Oh, yes, ma'am. No, no, ma'am. I am not an exterminator. Well, I am an exterminator, but not here. You don't have bugs, do you? Because if you do, I can make a referral. I'd get $25, and I wouldn't complain about that. Oh, how'd I... I'm sorry, what was your question again? How'd I get in here? Well, you see, there was a nice man, and he was coming in, and you know how you have the little keypad thing, and you swipe the little, the little card. Is it a card or a key fob? Well, he swiped his little card, and the, you know, the doors close slowly so they don't slam, and I just kind of pushed it on and just kind of, you know, squeaked in behind him, and then I just came and sat in here. Oh, no, I'm waiting for somebody. Yes, it's okay for me to be here. I mean, I'm not going to do anything untoward to anyone. I do know who I'm here to see, and she should be coming down any minute. I imagine she'll be coming down to eat her little lunch, and I'm going to be here. What's her name? Well, I don't feel that I should discuss this further with you. So, yes, ma'am. I've got on a hat and everything. I mean, do I look like I do anything to anybody? I wouldn't hurt a fly. I promise. Yes, ma'am. I promise I'll leave as soon as she finishes her lunch. I'll go. Yeah, I just really need to talk to her. I've got some presents for her. Yeah, I've been shopping. Okay. Oh, but nice to meet you too. Oh, my name's Carl. Oh, you don't want to shake my hand. My name's Carl. Oh, the coronavirus. Well, normally I would wear a mask, but see, I can't wear masks. No, well, my mother has neuropathy in her feet really bad. And I have night blindness. So it's just not conducive to our scenario. Yeah. See, I know it's complicated. This whole year's been complicated. I can't make heads or tails of it. Can you? It doesn't make a lick of sense, does it? I'd like to just ball it up and throw it in the trash. Wouldn't you? I do that. Well, she's coming. Yeah. What? Yeah. Oh, no. I don't know if she expects me or not. Ma'am, can you come sit here? I saved you a seat. No, well, you can sit with them later. I'd prefer if you sit with me. It is so... Yes, ma'am. I would love to have for you to have... You got me all kerfuffled here. I'd love for you to sit down. Yeah, I dusted that chair. I made sure there wasn't anything on it. And you can just put... What are you eating there? You just put your little lunch bag there. You got some healthy food, I bet. You look like you'd eat healthy. Now, I myself have lost some weight. You know, I've been through some reduction. I'm sorry. Oh, I do apologize. I didn't introduce myself. My name's Carl. You probably don't want to shake my hand because you know it's a cough. But that's fine. And I apologize for not wearing a mask. I know that's very rude, but see, like I was explaining to the lady there, you know, my mother's got her condition, I got mine, and you know, you just intermingle the two, and it didn't work out to where I could put anything on my face. You understand? I mean, I'm fine. I mean, I don't have anything. I mean, you know, I feel great. I don't imagine. It's a little cold in here, but I feel all right other than that. I don't believe I have a fever. I mean, you know, I touch my head and I feel fine. You ever just feel fine? You look nice. Am I allowed to say that? Is that harassment? Well, first of all, I want to introduce myself. My name's Carl. And I wanted to say thank you for you holding the elevator for me the other day. Well, that's how we met. You don't remember? It was Tuesday. I came in here because I had an appointment with the bank. You know, I had to come in. There was a little dispute. See, Mother, unbeknownst to me, took my debit card and she... No, she went to Talbot's and she bought a whole bunch of cardigans, and I didn't know a thing about it. Then I confronted Mother. I said, "Mother, did you take my card? Did you go to Talbot's again?" And she said, "No, Carl, I would never take your card. I use my own money." I said, "Mother." Well, she would not admit it, so I had to go to the bank. And then I tried to dispute it, but it didn't work out too well. But see, I didn't care. I didn't care. Oh, don't let me hold you up. You go ahead and take everything out there. I didn't care because it was fate. You see, I think destiny wanted her to keep her mouth shut, although she's a lying. She tells tales. And it's like to try my patience, just worn it to a thin little strand. But I'm glad she did it because I think fate wanted her to. Because that way, I had to come in here and get on the elevator. And you saw me coming up the hallway there, and you ducked your head out of the elevator. You said, "Are you coming?" And then I felt really bad because I had a dirty thought when you said that. I mean, I'll just admit, I just had this dirty thought. And then, Mother always told me, you don't have dirty thoughts around women because that's inappropriate. You don't think dirty things. You save that for private time. But when you said that, it just hit me funny. I couldn't help it. I mean, I'm a man. I can't. And you're pretty. Well, I saw your head. Your head looked pretty. And you said, "Are you coming?" And it just, I mean, I was going to say something. And I realized that'd be really inappropriate. Like, maybe later, but I didn't, because I realized, Carl, that's wrong. You don't think like that. You wait till you're in a relationship, and then I guess the dirty thoughts can come in. But I don't actually know because I don't have a relationship at this point. Well, see, I had something special with this cashier at the thrift store, but it didn't work out. No, she was too clingy and needy, and Mother didn't care for her, and so just it didn't work out. But so I'm a single man. And are you single? Well, you can tell me. I mean, it may not be any of my business, but sometimes I think I like to be very giving, and even if something's not my business, I like to make it my business because I like to help people. See, I could help you. You don't have to be single. Just you don't have to tell me. You don't have to be single. I mean, see, I'm single, and see, I'm assuming you are because you don't want to talk about it. I figure if you have a boyfriend, you say something. But yeah, that was another thing with the lady at the thrift store. She kept saying she had a boyfriend and he was a doctor, and I know, right? What are the odds of that? I knew she was lying. So, you're single. I'm just assuming you're single, I'm single. We could get together and then we don't have to be single no more. We could just be a couple. Well, don't make up your mind yet because I brought some stuff I thought might help assuage your opinion, assuage, swayed. I got this word of the day calendar and I thought it would make me, smarter, but sometimes I think I use the words wrong and it just excoriates everything, and I don't know. But I'm a smart man, right? Let me tell you, I've had some good jobs. I worked at Flo's. You ever go to Flo's? I was a good man there. I sold refrigerators to lovely ladies like yourself. And then I worked at My Best for a day. But see, there was this misunderstanding, okay? I brought in some of my Betamax tapes. And all I was doing, like you do, you bring them in, you want to go through the clearance bin, see if you can swap out your Betamaxes for a DVD. Well, I happened to just accidentally drop a few of the Betamaxes down in there. And at the same time, I didn't mean to, just picked up the DVDs by mistake, stuck them in my bag, and I set off an alarm or something. They thought I was stealing. I said, "I wasn't stealing. I didn't even realize these weren't the Betamaxes." I mean, if you look at a DVD and a Betamax, they're practically identical. But they didn't see it that way. And Mr. Tompkins, that man a jerk, you know, he fired me. He fired me. Would not give me another chance. Said, don't you ever come back in my best. I'm not going to forget this. And he didn't even give me my Betamax tapes back. I'm still ill about it. You know how hard it is to find Betamax tapes? About as hard as it is to find a Betamax player. But I don't want to toot my own horn, but I have a Betamax player myself. Yeah. You know, I'm an accomplished worldly man. I'm very proud of my Betamax. It's not a euphemism, it's a literal thing. You're young. You may not even know what a Betamax is. It's not, you know what a Betamax is? Well, it's kind of like a VCR. Do you remember those? Long. See, I always thought Betamax better than VHS, but they lost that contest. I'm still not sure why it was Betamax better, but I got off subject, didn't I? I'm sorry. So, I like that salad. What is that? Is that chicken? Tofu? Why would you put tofu in there? Did you do that deliberately? Long. What does it taste like? No, I won't be taking any. They don't offer it to me because I sure won't. Is that cranberries? I would take a cranberry. No. Okay, I won't touch it. We're not that familiar yet, I understand. So anyway, you want to tell me now if you're single or not? I got gifts. See, I went shopping today. Well, you know, Mother said, you know, after I lost the job at My Best, she said, you need to get out more. Well, I don't know what that would do to fix the situation because, you know, I got fired because they thought I was stealing. I don't know how getting out is going to fix a misunderstanding. Does that make any sense to you? Mother's very contradictory sometimes. She just lays into bed and knits. And she has this big old fluffy cat that just lays on her all day. And they just sit there and they look at me and they judge me. And I try to get comfortable. I got my recliner and trying to watch my programs. They just look at me. And they just judge me. I can't stand people that judge. I don't judge people. So anyway, are you single? I figure you'd tell me eventually. If I just keep asking you, tell me something. Because, I came a lot. I went to a lot of trouble coming here today. It's my lunch hour. See, I work for the pest control company. They gave me this hat. I didn't buy this or anything. They just gave me this for nothing. See, I am a bug. I'm an insect control expert. And, you know, that takes a lot of education. That takes a lot of knowledge. I mean, we're practically physicians. We have to learn all about bug science. You know, you have to learn about how the different types of bug sprays, what kills, how does it kill, the neurotransmitters and neuroticism. No, that's not right. Neuropathy, that's what Mother has. You know, I just had a thought. See, these sprays, these poisons that we use, they act on the nervous systems of these insects. Now, this is purely hypothetical, and I'm just pulling this out of thin air, but if somebody had neuropathy, do you think something that acted on the nervous system would, you know, like, you know, the X's on the I's, you'd think it'd do that? Well, I don't either. I'm sure it's just a coincidence that neuropathy and nervous system stuff sounds similar. But say you had, all right, again, total hypothetical. Say you had a 100-pound judgmental old woman, about 4'11", without her shoes. How much you reckon it'd take? And would you use a powder? You'd think if you mix it into like a lasagna, you reckon it would? You could taste that. I guess it would depend on the type. Bear makes some good stuff, or so I hear. I mean, I wouldn't know, and it doesn't matter because all I do is kill bugs. But But it doesn't matter. I don't want to talk about bugs while you're trying to eat. That's very inappropriate of me, and I do apologize for that. Well, I tell you what, I got to get back to work, but I'm going to show you what I got you, okay? Because you are very special to me. What was your name again? See, to me, you look like a Melissa to me. I figured your name would be Melissa. The hat, I don't know, your hair, the wavy. You got kind of long, very pretty hair, because that's the first thing I noticed. You tucked your head out of that elevator. It's kind of funny, though, because you just look like a disembodied head, and you said, "Are you coming?" And then I just forgot what I was thinking after that, because then I just got tickled with myself, and then I felt ashamed, and I remember what my Bible school teacher used to say about that, and that, you know, you don't talk like that, and the mother reinforced that. And so then I forgot all about it, but I just thought that'd be your name. Well, it's very nice to meet you, and you are very special to me. It took a little digging to figure out where you worked. I mean, I had to come back, and, you know, I had to wait around for you to come to work the next day and then follow you in, and, you know, I was going to talk to you, but it didn't feel right. The fact that you didn't recognize me bothered me a little bit, that you didn't even remember me from Tuesday, that, you know, we had that moment together. I mean, you were so kind. Nobody holds the elevator for me. If anything, they slam it in my face, and then they say, "Coronavirus, social distance," and won't let me get near them. You seem really nice. So how is it somebody as nice as you doesn't have a boyfriend? You like boys, don't you? Because I'm a boy. See, that's what I was saying. Yeah, I'm a boy. You know, you like boys. We could get together, and then you wouldn't have to be single anymore. I mean, you know, that way you could tell everybody you got a fella, and you wouldn't have to answer those questions anymore. You know, you go to your family reunion, and they say, "Carl," or, you know, "How come you don't have somebody? How come you're still single? Aren't you ever going to get married?" And then your mother chimes in and, you know, gangs up on you. "Yeah, Carl, never had grandchildren." Make you feel like dirt. I mean, I'm not exactly a spring chicken anymore. I get reminded all the time. We go to the ladies' auxiliary stuff. I only go because they have these really good hot dogs. It's not that I like that kind of stuff, because then they play bingo, and then they talk about crochet and athlete's foot. And you would, what is it with old women and athlete's foot? They get it all the time. How do they get athlete's foot? They don't do anything. I think they get it at the Y. They go there and go swimming, and they don't put on their flip-flops. I've told Mother 100 times. I said, "With your neuropathy, you need to be..." Oh, I'm sorry. You're right. It's very inappropriate to do that, to talk like that's nasty. I'm sorry. When I get in your presence, I just get so talkative. I'm not normally that talkative. I mean, you can ask anybody. I'm quiet. I'm just like, you know, I don't say 2 words. You just bring out my chatterbox, and that's not a euphemism either. I wouldn't bring that out. I mean, not on a first date. Can I show you what I brought you? Because, see, I went shopping. See, Mother, so she said I need to get out more. Well, I said, "Mother, I just got this new job. I'm a bug control specialist." She said, "I don't give a crap. You need to get out. Get out of this house. I'm tired of looking at you. Why do you grunt groan all the time?" I said, "I don't know." So I got out, and I went to this other thrift store. Now, how do you feel about thrift stores? Do they bother you? Because some people are skeeved out by them. I'm not. I'm not too good to shop at a thrift store. I think they're fine. Well, that's another thing we got in common. See, we just click. We just got it all. I think it's like the perfect package. See, that, how old are you? See, that's not too bad. Well, how old do you think I am? You don't want to guess. Well, whatever you're thinking is probably around that. Yeah, I'm not a spring chicken, but I'm not old. I mean, I wouldn't say Mother's old. Mother's older than dirt, and she won't die. You ever see these people? Like, they just live out of spite. They go through all kinds of trials and tribulations. You just, like, you can't kill them. Like, God can't call them home because they just keep giving him the finger. Like, I ain't dying. I'm going to just make everybody's life miserable. I'm going to keep living, and then nobody going to get my house, and my son can think I'm going to die and leave him this house. I ain't leaving him nothing. Sorry. That was hypothetical, too. I don't even know. I'm talking about other people. This first thing, just forget about that. This first thing, look, isn't this cute? Now, see, this to me fulfills a fantasy I've had all my life. And it's not like perverted or, you know, anything. No, it's totally appropriate, except I just realized the little tiger, he has a square butt and no tail. He's got no tail. It don't matter. He's got a barcode and no tail. I always wanted to take my girlfriend to the fair. And you know where you throw the balloons and you pop them and you win a prize and you get to give it to her and she's just overly excited. She gets just inappropriately excited over it. See, I imagined that I could, but like we've been at the fair and we've been walking around eating funnel cakes and fried Snickers bars. And you ever had fried butter? It's surprisingly delicious. And then I win this. And see, then I could just hand it to you and you kiss me on the cheek. Like, you could just kiss me now. You could just give me a kiss here. No? I mean, I told you I'm not sick. I already told you I'm fine. I don't have the Rona. You can do it. I mean, I ain't nobody looking. It's nothing wrong with it if you're a couple. Well, maybe after you finish your food, I'll just set this over. Do you like it? He's got a vacant look in his face. Look, see, he just slowly turns to you. Mother does that sometimes. Sometimes she'll do that to me at night. We'll be watching. See, we like to watch old episodes of Johnny Carson, and she'll just turn, like, the glow of the TV will be on her. And I'm sitting over here, and she'll just do it right here. And I'll feel eyeballs on me. I'll look over there, and she's just staring at me like not blinking. I think she's trying to cast a spell on me or something. I'm not really sure, because every time I ask her about it, she just does this right here. And she just goes back to Johnny Carson. I don't know, man. I don't get it. But anyway, I'm going to leave that for you. You keep that. And then we can just see, you can show that to all your lady friends and tell them that your boyfriend got you that at the carnival. You don't have to tell them it came from Goodwill. Just tell them it came from the carnival. I won't say any difference. Now, I didn't know your clothing sizes. I mean, what are your measurements? Do you know your measurements? I bet if you stood up, I could probably tell. I mean, I could just kind of run my hands down and get a feel. I mean, I don't mean like, I'm not trying to cop a feel. I mean get a feel for your measurements, you know, like, No. I figured I couldn't go wrong with a t-shirt. I found this t-shirt and it made me excited. And look at his shirt. Now, you may not know what that is. That there is a 1978 Corvette pace car. That is the 25th anniversary of the Corvette. That's my dream car. And I don't mean to be too forward, but when I saw this in the thrift store, it was just another sign. I've been getting signs ever since you held that elevator from me. It all started with Mother's illicit trip to Talbot's, and then I saw this shirt. And I said, it's a sign because it's my dream car. And I'm going to buy it for my dream girl. I'll just say it, my dream girl. I'm going to buy it for her. And then we can wear it on our dates. And so then I can see you and my favorite car. Yes. So I would wash this before I wore it because it came from a thrift store. And I don't think it has bugs, but you know, it's good practice to wash it. So I'm going to put that there. And how do you feel so far? Are you feeling pretty good? You think maybe you want to have a relationship with me yet? Well, don't answer because there's more. Now, I noticed that you look like you exercise, and I think that's wonderful. As I was mentioning before, see, I've been losing weight, and I've been trying to take better care of myself. My clothes are big on me. I've been doing this thing. I don't know if you've heard of it. It's called fasting. And see, fasting is when you don't eat for long periods of time. And Mother told me about it. She heard about it on Dr. Oz. I was at work, but she was watching Dr. Oz. And she said, Carl, you're getting fat. You need to fast. And I said, I don't know what that is. And she explained, you just quit eating. I said, Mother, I'll die. And then she got a gleam in her eye. And then she shook a little bit. She said, no, Carl. You don't stop eating altogether. You just stop occasionally, and then you eat once or twice a day. I said, Mother, that's stupid. I don't want to do that. She said, it's not bad. But she kept saying that I needed to do something. So I hate exercise. But with this job as a bug specialist, I end up going under houses a lot, and I almost got stuck. So I figured I probably need to do something. So I started fasting. And like I explained, it's where you don't eat. So what I do is, 7 a.m., I eat. And then I don't eat again until 7 p.m., and then I don't eat anything else. Now, I tried just drinking coffee to get me through, but that had its own side effects, and I won't go into that because it's not something appropriate. But I switched to water. Have you heard that drinking water is good for you? Yes, it cleanses you. So I've been drinking that. I figured water would be a good option. So I drink that, and then I just eat twice a day. I don't snack. And I haven't lost any weight, but I've started having hallucinations, and that has been very entertaining. Now, what made me lose weight was a hallucination. See, I had these scary visions. I had these visions of these monsters, and they were chasing me. And I started running. And I ran and I ran. I run all the time. I don't even have to drive anymore. I just ran here. And see, that's what made me lose the weight. It wasn't a fasting. It was the delusions, the hallucinations. But don't take that as a sign that I'm not a good man for you, because I am the perfect man for you. I'm gainfully employed. I have knowledge of different jobs. And I've only been fired 4 times. And it was all misunderstandings. I mean, I don't think they even count, honestly. But you look like you exercise. So I bought you some pants that you can wear while you exercise. Now, you look like you would appreciate some colorful pants. See, now you can go to your early morning lady exercises. What do you do? You go to a boot camp. Well, see, what kind of boot camp? Are there Marines there? Because I'm a little intimidated by them. No? Okay, good. See, you can wear this. Now, what do you think of all these colors? See, they're like you. They're vibrant and just nice and stretchy. I mean, I don't think you're stretchy, but these pants are. And I don't know what size you wear, but I thought they're stretchy. So, I mean, not that they need to stretch, but you know, it'd be great for you. So I got you these pants. I'm not done. And also, see, I was looking at all kinds of lady clothes in the thrift store, and I started worrying that people might think and I was doing something, like I was going to steal. I wasn't going to do that. I was just looking, you know, for you. I mean, I was thinking about you the whole time. And I thought about your jawline and how sharp it is. Very angular. And I saw this shirt. I thought this would be perfect. I thought it would go really well with your jawline. Now, what do you think of that? It's got a hood on it and a drawstring. Look at that pretty fabric. So I thought that would be good, especially when the weather starts to get cold. You could put this on, you know, if you're still working out outside. You could dress in layers and not freeze to death. Maybe I could start coming to boot camp with you. What do y'all do? Just some little jumping jacks and then drink some tea, or you just put on some lipstick and do each other's hair? I mean, what do y'all do? Oh, I don't care for that. Circuit training and CrossFit type stuff. Doesn't that mess up your makeup? You don't wear makeup to the, really? So you get all sweaty? Wow. I just can't imagine you doing anything like that. It's not very ladylike. I don't know. It's just, I just never thought of you that way. It just doesn't sound very feminine to go and get all sweaty. And so you do like burpees and stuff. And well, I won't hold it against you. I mean, I just imagine, you know, ladies' exercise classes very differently, I guess. I just imagine maybe you just do a little jump rope and then sit down and draw, you know, pictures or make some birthday cards or just gossip. You know how women are, they just gossip. But anyway, you can look nice. You don't have to look ugly. I mean, you can wear some pretty clothes and stuff. I thought you'd like some brightly colored things. Well, if you don't like that, you're probably not going to like this too much. I found this bag. Now, I really enjoy the fact that you seem to be whimsical. I noticed that on your purse you have a little cat keychain thing on your purse, so I thought you had a whimsical side. Do you not? See, I consider that false advertising. I mean, no offense, but I'm starting to get a little turned off by your whole... Or, I mean, I'm not going to throw in the towel yet, but, I hang in there. I just thought maybe you would like this because, see, it's got cupcakes on it and then skulls. So, it's kind of like saying if you eat like this all the time, you're going to die. It don't matter because you're going to die anyway. You might as well eat that. It has a little pull on it with a doohickey on it. It's from Yak Pack. I mean... I'm not saying you talk a lot. Honestly, you seem real quiet. You haven't said two words since I sat down. I mean, I know you're eating, but is that Diet Coke? You know those things will give you cancer. You can't drink Diet Coke. Yeah, mother would not approve of that. I don't know. See, well, I know they say it's fine. It's not, though, because that's ultimately, you can't drink that. I mean, why do you even bother working out if you don't drink that? You're just a whole bucket of contradictions. I'm starting to feel betrayed a little bit. But see, look, this Yak Pack, it comes with this big wide strap. That way, if you have a shoulder pad in your dress, it'll just rest on it, you know, and it won't tear up your shoulder. And it's adjustable too, so you can make it longer or shorter. I wish other things in life were adjustable, but God didn't make them that way. So you can put your laptop in here, and it even has a little handle there. And a zipper. You could keep your lipstick in here, maybe some lady products. Whatever you need, you could put feminine hygiene things in here. Whatever you need, it goes in this little pouch. And see, this flips up and you put your laptop in there. Yeah, that way you could have a nice fashionable bag for your laptop. What do you think of that? It'd be better than that boring one you have, that gray one, so you can have one with some personality to it. But if you don't like it, I'll just give it to somebody. I don't know. Now, I know you're going to like this, and not only are you going to like this, you're going to like what's in it. Look here. Now, this is innovation right here. Look. This is a bag made of bags. I'm not kidding. Look. The whole bag is made of wound up paper bag, plastic bags. from all over. I found this at the thrift store, and I said, oh, she'll love it. She will just love it. And look, it's big enough to hold all kinds of things. You could about fit somebody in that bag. Look at how pretty that is. Now, you won't find a bag like this anywhere. Not only that, I got stuff in it for you. I have these at the house. Mother picked them up at a yard sale, and she would probably rip my head off for giving them away. These are markers. I don't know if you've ever heard of them. These are called markers. And see, these are special because they're cosmic color. Kind of like you. I mean, I see you like my cosmic goddess. You are. Even if you're not what you pretend to be, and you're a bit of a hypocrite because you put little cat dingle dangles on your bag, and then you say you're not quirky, and you drink diet soda, but you say you work out. I don't understand you sometimes. You probably take Vivarin and NyQuil at the same time. What would that do, you reckon? I don't know. Your head would probably blow up if you did that. But these are a limited edition. See, you can't get these every day. Kind of like you, I think you're sort of a limited edition because I think you are the girl for me. Now, I think you need some work. I think you are definitely going to be a project. First thing we got to do is get rid of that Diet Coke. And then we need to work on, maybe we could just take your personality and sculpt it. See, we'll start with markers. Like, we'll get you to do different color combinations with the markers. And you can see the potential of just coordinating your colors a little bit. We could expand your wardrobe. You know, I'll let you have this bag for your laptop. We'll swap out that boring purse of yours with this. You could put all your stuff in here, you know. And then we'll start experimenting with your makeup. Now, I want you to be open-minded about this right here. I found this at the thrift store. Now, it's used makeup, but see, that's another thing. You got to learn to relax and not worry about it. I'm sure the person that used it before was fine. I thought this would be something you'd like here. See, now, as part of your new personality, we're going to make you really, really fancy. See, with this LA Colors, this is a glam palette. We can make you glamorous and quirky. You would be like a triple threat if you were glamorous and perky and knew how to make lasagna. I think you would be wonderful. See, you can make lasagna for my mother. You can make lasagna for my mother, and then that way, if anything happened, it wouldn't be my fault. No. That's just a plot from a movie that mother was watching the other night on Lifetime. I didn't know. I wasn't talking about you literally doing anything to my mother. I mean, you wouldn't do it on purpose. Like, say, what if this was a plot for a movie, right? So, let's say you came over and you made lasagna. And then, okay, this is the movie. This isn't real. But you made lasagna. And then when you weren't looking, somebody came along and put some powder in it and mixed it in. And just kind of put cheese on top of that. See, that way, you didn't see it. Nobody else saw it. But you were the one that made the lasagna. And I could just appear to be elsewhere. Huh. Apropos of nothing, what are you doing tomorrow night? Would you like to come over and have dinner at my house? I know I'm being forward, but, you know, I believe you got to be bold to get anywhere in life. You got to take a chance. See, you could do your makeover. Get your girlfriends, your lady friends to come over and do your makeup. Do away with all that taupe and blah on your eyes. You know, go for some splashy colors. You know, maybe put on some colorful pants. You know, do something to your hair. No offense, but just kind of lays there right now. I mean, you could do something to it. And maybe we could have, what could we have? Oh, I know. We could make some lasagna. Yeah, all this talk of lasagna's got my mind working, and I'm thinking we really need to make some lasagna and have Mother participate in the dining experience. In fact, we can make two pans of lasagna. We can make one for you and me and a little one for her. What do you think about that? Well, I'm gonna put that right there. You're gonna have to check your calendar. I can wait. You can do it right now. Oh, you don't want to do it now? Are you single? I figure eventually you'll trip up and answer me. Why don't you just tell me? Well, I figure you must be, or you would have said something by now. I mean, my last girlfriend, the cashier at the thrift store, she would not stop talking about her doctor boyfriend. Funny, I never saw him. She talked about him all the time. Never saw him. She always said he was, being an intern and he was busy. I think she was full of it. I was well rid of her. It's a good thing, too, because it wasn't long after that I happened to see you with your head sticking out of that elevator, and I fell in love with that head. I said that disembodied head has done took my heart. Ooh, now, these next two gifts, I got two more things here for you. It's not dope. Are you into that kind of thing? Well, it's not that. It's not crack. Okay, these are little rocks. It's fluorite. It's not fluoride. It's not that evil stuff. No, it's little purple rocks. Now, these are kind of do-it-yourself gifts here. But you look really innovative. I think you can handle it. They got holes in them. You just need some string. And then you string them on there. And bippity-boppity-boo, you got a bracelet. Or an anklet. Or whatever you want. See, I got that for you. I thought you'd like that. And then here. Look here. It's not worms. Kind of looks like worms, but it's not. It's more beads. Look at these beads. They look like mermaids. They look like little mermaids, don't they? Little strings. So again, you're gonna have to string these. I mean, they're on a string, but you can't really wear them like that. I mean, you could, but you'll have to restring them. I don't believe they'd fit over your head. They might. But so you string these, and then you can wear them. So it's only a little bit of effort on your part, and then you have a really nice necklace. So if you consider all the stuff I bought for you today, I think you have to decide that I mean, it's a no-brainer. I mean, you gotta see. I'm the right man for you. I am upstanding. Not literally at the moment, because right now I'm sitting down, but I have a wide variety of manly necklaces. I have this one that I got at the mall, and it's not quite rounded, it's a little square, and it's braided, and it matches my shirt. I know how to color coordinate, which most men don't. I'm gonna own my own home one of these days. Maybe sooner if you'll make that lasagna. But yeah, one day I'm on my own home. And I can drive in the daytime. I can't drive at night. My night blindness. And I'm very devoted most of the time. And so I think you gotta say, you're gonna be my girlfriend and we're gonna be a couple. So what do you say? Will you come over and make dinner tomorrow night? That sure would be good. I'm tired eating popcorn. Mother won't cook for me anymore. I quit buying her candy canes. She's hooked on candy canes. She just eats them all the time. I said, Mother, it's not Christmas. Quit eating the dang candy canes. I have to order them on Amazon because you can't find them in the stores in August. And it'd be nice to have a nice meal that doesn't come out of a bag. That's all I'm saying. So, What do you say? No. You're saying no to me. Did you miss all the stuff I did? Is that lost on you? Do you have any idea how much thought went into these presents? Well, I don't know what I'm going to tell Mother. She's expecting you to come over. She said she wanted to meet you. I said, sure, I'll bring her over. And now she's going to accuse me again of making up girlfriends. She said I keep making them up, and she just never gets to see them, you know. Like Clark Kent and Superman, just with girlfriends. Well, it's probably for the best. I mean, with your Diet Coke and your fake bling, your fake flair, it probably wouldn't have worked out anyway. Well, you go on to keep them things. I'll tell you what, though, you're not getting the main thing. I hid it under my chair where you wouldn't see it. This was supposed to be the special reveal. But since you have chosen the way of misery, you won't get it. It's too late. Don't try to make up to me now, because you don't get this now. This goes to a special, special lady that appreciates me and knows how to fully appreciate everything about me. It's the ultimate gift that you could bestow upon a girlfriend. You won't get it. I'm going to show it to you because I want you to see what you're missing out on. I want you to feel the sting that you experience when you reject me. This is what you won't get. One day, a lovely lady will. Look at that right there. You see what I said right there? Most important position in the world right there. And I don't mean that dirty. Only the most special woman in my life will ever get this mother mug. And what do you mean that's weird? There's nothing weird about it. What are you saying? You saying you don't love your mother? You saying mothers don't matter? What's wrong with you? Are you the devil? Of course mothers matter. That's why this mug is so special. And I got it for half price at the thrift store because it's got a blue dot on the tag. That means it's good. It was 50 cents and it's the perfect thing, and you won't get it because you done messed up. But I'll let you keep everything else, kind of like a parting gift from the Carl game show, because you really going to suffer, and at least with that, you can console yourself a little bit. One day, some woman will appreciate me, and I'll give her this mug because she will know how important it is to take that esteemed spot in my life. Oh, well. Hey, your coworker over there, what was her, the one that was talking to me when you came in? Can she cook? You reckon she can make some lasagna? Oh, no reason. I might go ask her about it, though.